गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, एज यू नो सो फार वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द ह्यूमन एक्सक्रीटरी सिस्टम. ह्यूमन एक्सक्रीटरी सिस्टम कंप्राइजेज ऑफ किडनी, यूरेटर्स, यूरिनरी ब्लैडर एंड यूरेथ्रा. इन द प्रीवियस क्लास आई हैव ऑलरेडी गिवन यू द ब्रीफ इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ ह्यूमन एक्सक्रीटरी सिस्टम, व्हाट इज द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ ह्यूमन एक्सक्रीटरी सिस्टम एंड व्हाट इज द मेन एक्सक्रीटरी ऑर्गन ऑफ द सिस्टम. सो एज अ रिकैप, I must tell that what is the importance of human excretory system. So importance is it removes the nitrogenous waste from the body. This system is very important to remove the nitrogenous waste from the body. And this nitrogenous waste is generated by the digestion of proteins basically. Second thing is this excretory system, which is also known as urinary system, it helps in maintaining the water balance in the body. And the process of maintaining the correct amount of water in the body is known as osmoregulation. This is called osmoregulation. Body always tries to make the or try to maintain the correct amount of salts and water in the body. And which system helps in maintaining the correct amount of salts and water in the body? That is the urinary system or excretory system. And that process of maintaining the correct amount of water and salts in the body is known as osmoregulation. So today we have learned about two things. So what is the importance of excretory system? If somebody asks you what is the importance of kidney, the answer will be same. Okay, so because kidneys are the main organ in this system, so answer will be the same. It helps in removal of the nitrogenous waste. It maintains osmoregulation. Or what is osmoregulation? The process of maintaining the correct amount of water and salts in the body. Not only this, it maintains the blood pressure also. If you want to write this, you can write as a third point, to maintain the blood volume or to maintain the blood pressure, because mainly the blood pressure or the blood volume is related with the percentage of water in that is plasma content. So you can write third point as maintaining the blood volume, because blood volume is related with directly or indirectly related with plasma. Plasma is the liquid part of blood, or you can say blood volume or blood pressure. So three things are maintained with the excretory system, that is removal of the nitrogenous waste, osmoregulation and maintaining blood pressure. So this we have already learned. Now you know kidneys, they are reddish brown bean shaped structures. They are present in the abdominal cavity, and left kidney slightly higher than the right kidney, because you know above right kidney you have got the liver. Okay, and each kidney has a number of nephrons present. Nephrons are the structural and functional unit of kidney. This we have already done. Now comes the ureter, second part. But before that, I must draw the urinary system. This is the kidney, bean shaped kidney. Here I can draw the another one. Now these are the ureters, and this is the urinary bladder. Okay, I must draw once again to make it better. This is bean shaped structured kidney. So this is right side, so it will be little lower, left will be little higher in position. From this side we have to make the notch. So this is the kidney, these are the ureters, and this is the urinary bladder, and this one is the urethra. Now one more thing is about the artery, renal artery. Renal is related to kidney. The term we use is renal, as we have used the term pulmonary. Whenever we say something related to lungs, we say pulmonary. Related to kidney, we will say renal. So this is renal artery, which is having oxygenated blood. You know, arteries, they always carry oxygenated blood, and it gets divided and it goes to the both kidneys, left and right. This is right kidney and this is the left kidney. Okay, now we have got vein also. we will draw a vein with the blue color. So this is renal vein. Why renal? Because it is related to kidney. So renal vein going in both the kidneys. So renal vein carries deoxygenated blood, but it carries pure blood. So you have to understand this, that in this renal artery, which is having oxygenated blood but impure, when it is coming from the heart, it carries oxygenated but impure blood. So it goes to the both the kidneys. Here many nephrons are there present. Nephrons are the structural and functional unit of kidney, and they do their work. What is the work of nephron? Same, removal of the nitrogenous waste from the body. Okay, and after removing the nitrogenous waste and extra water, that is urine, it comes down in the ureter. Urine comes down in the ureter, and the blood, which is pure but it is deoxygenated, it goes to the renal vein. So it comes in the renal artery, it goes to the both the kidneys, there it gets purified. Okay, and after purification, it comes back, the blood comes back to the renal vein, and the urine comes to the ureter. So this is the whole process. Then it is stored for the some time in the urinary bladder. It is a sac means bag-like structure, muscular bag-like structure, which is stretchable, and then it is passed from the urethra. So this is the whole structure of your human excretory system. So now we will study one by one. We know about the kidneys. Kidneys are the main excretory organ, and the urine comes down to the urinary bladder from kidneys through ureters. Ureters are long muscular tubes of 30 centimeter length, and they arise from the hilus. Hilus is a region like this. For example, this is the kidney. This notch like structure is called hilus. This area is having many things. Ureter come down here, then it has got artery also, which comes and goes there. Then it has got vein, renal vein also, which comes here. So this is called hilus. This notch like structure is called hilus. Inside hilus, the renal artery, renal vein, they enter, and not only this, the ureter also come down. Now you know the ureters are long muscular tubes, almost of 30 centimeter length. They arise from the hilus and open into a bag like structure or muscular sac like structure called urinary bladder. It carries urine from the kidney to urinary bladder. What is the function of ureter? It is a tube like structure which carry the urine from the kidney to the a bag like structure called urinary bladder, and urine comes down with the help of peristalsis. You have learned this word in human digestive system. Peristalsis is the regular contraction and relaxation of the muscles. So with the help of contraction and relaxation of the muscles of ureters, the urine comes down and it gets stored in a bag-like structure called urinary bladder. So this is how it happens. Now urinary bladder, it is pear-shaped sac in the abdomen, but lower abdomen you can say. It stores urine, and its storage capacity is 300 to 800 ml. Then urethra, it is a tube that carry urine from urinary bladder to outside. The last portion of human excretory or urinary system is the urethra. It is the terminal point of the urinary bladder. This is urinary bladder, and this one is the urethra. It is 4 cm long only in female, but in male it is 20 cm long. So these points are important. In female it passes only urine, but in case of male it passes urine plus semen both. Means it is very important part of male reproductive system also, that we will study later on in reproductive system. So this is how your urinary system is all about. You have to remember, you have to learn the functions of each and every organ. Revise well, draw the diagram from NCERT. Thank you very much. Revise well.